doing a little bit more of Japan. And this game we're looking at is called Figureheads. And we're here with Adware World Combi.
Hey, what's up, people? Give me a shout out or tweet online and just slate my ability not to understand what's going on anymore in reality.
And the particular cases whenever these games are actually coming from the Hong Kong or Japanese stores, I have to help you navigate the menus. So feel free to start this one up and we'll have a wee look. Figureheads, from what my knowledge is a multiplayer arena combat shooter for mech warriors, essentially. Big and robot bosses, tiny little soldiers.
That's all I needed to hear. Robots killing people. Each other. Robot wars.
After other stuff that we've been watching recently, where we've been seeing the incline of AI to actually take over our world, from our music and Hatsune Miku to the sexuality with Galgun Double Peace, I think this might actually be a good catharsis for you. So it's actually to burn through and kill.
Left or right?
They left.
Oh, with this one?
Yeah.
Grand. Look at that.
Oh, you circles. Remember the circles. You remember your circles.
Dear Japan, nice. Seriously, get over the rest of the planet. X. X is the fucking button.
Yeah, X. No, but X is cancel and circle is confirm.
No.
Circle is okay. X is no. Does that not make sense?
Not really, no.
Ah. Okay, so this is made by Square Enix. Square Enix have a really good run of games coming out lately. They've, of course, had Final Fantasy XV. They have Nier Automata that came out this week.
I never even heard of that one. Care about Final Fantasy.
Nier Automata is actually a game made by Platinum Games. You ever played Devil May Cry? Or...
Heard of, never played it though.
A lot of those games are all they're all spectacle fighters. They're designed around the idea of actually having the biggest combos possible and doing the most damage possible in the most spectacular way possible. Bayonetta is another one of their games as well. They do a lot of pickup for other companies. They actually design games. They use their engines and then put other people's characters into them. They've done it with Legend of Korra for Nickelodeon. They've done it with Transformers for IDW.
Which one exactly? I accidentally read the terms and conditions in that previous thing.
Okay. I would say it would be the far right one, yeah. No, took you back.
No, see, I read that one. Yeah. So I'm assuming maybe options.
No, but you have to agree to the terms and conditions, man.
It didn't. That was credits. Didn't worthy agree. Sort of.
this is the problem of always playing Japanese games.
And then forward didn't do shit.
Scroll down to the bottom. What's that in the bottom right corner?
I clicked it and I got nothing. Takes you to the top.
Alright.
Where's the I'm not a robot thing to click?
Press. It's not going to be in this. So press X to close. And then press on the first one. Okay.
Motherfucker.
brought it back up again. X to close. Then try the middle one. There you go.
Yay!
Process of elimination, my friend. Process of elimination.
I hope so. Because I want a robot to beat up another robot. This is real steel. This is huge Jackman.
Huge Jackman?
Yeah, huge Jackman.
This is going to be more of a big arena kind of thing. You're actually going to be shooting guns at these giant robots, so this is probably designed to be a multiplayer online game experience where
they're firing Cupid's fucking heart somewhere at some person.
You played that game, Alien Nation, was it, that we were playing at one point with the kind of top down shooter? Could be a bit like that.
Maybe? I don't know. Can't remember. Did I? Is there a video? Did we record it?
No, I think you actually were playing it just on my console at one point, where we actually didn't record it as an episode, because I was playing, I did a video of myself on it, but I think you actually did one as well.
That doesn't sound like me. I did something?
Okay. I did things? I did things without being prompted to do so. So obviously we're actually getting a little bit of backstory to the world of Figurehead. Asteroid strikes all over the planet. Humans probably fucked beyond all belief, because there's no air to breathe, no light to see, and all of us are dead.
So, pretty much an average sort of really shitty, dodgy strip club. With a lack of atmosphere, it's dark and gritty.
Oh, is that? Yeah. That was such a bizarre, tenuous link. Are you still sexually aroused from playing Galgun? Is it actually still in your head?
If you're, there's no way I'm ever going to be sexually aroused by that game. If somebody can be, if you are sexually aroused by that, fair enough, shackle yourself to your basement and don't leave the house. You weirdo. But no, yeah, that was a weird segue, but it was
a statement of opinion.
The planet was being bashed by a lot of space sperm.
Yeah, it's all space sperm, and of course we actually have
bunny ears.
Yeah,
Jesus Christ!
Do you think about the mutations that are going to happen after they've actually had giant asteroid crashes? You're going to have to rabbits will evolve to survive.
This is Tank Girl overall again, when she fucks the fucking kangaroo guy, isn't it?
More than likely.
Yeah, fair enough.
Well, since as you can see, there was actually showing like four different character types and four different robot types, so I'm assuming you're going to be able to pick different classes of robots. Ones that are going to be faster at running and striking, ones that are going to be flying in the air, ones that are going to be big massive tanks that carry massive Gatling guns. So
one that transforms from a truck and a trailer to a talking guy with a big sword who says, you know, Unicron, we must not, you know, fucking Optimus Prime is probably going to be knocking around.
Roll out.
Roll out.
Thought you were made of sterner stuff, Megatron.
Oh, God.
Till all are one. You mean that voice?
Yeah, that guy. Yeah. Well, not Leonard Nimoy, but the other guy. I can't remember his actual voice. But
I can't remember his on my head either.
If you know who it is we're talking about, please let us know, because I will forget to Google this and figure it out.
Yeah.
But I do like the fact that there's a lot of shooting going on, so... So this is going to be a far, far shout from fucking... What, Operation 6?
Operation 7.
Seven,
No, don't worry. No, let's say Operation 7. We're not going to forget Operation 7 ever again. But look, you can see that there's large bosses. There's actually customizable combat.
Oh, that would look like... what do you call it? Chappy? You look like Chappy.
Yeah, well, I mean, that's it's going to be like the light combat ones, and then the ones are going to be doing sword hand-to-hand combat. It appears that all of these are like... I don't know if these are actually like automated devices or they're actually like exosuits that you're inside.
Damn, that's one badass big boss up there. Also, I just realized how... No, yeah, that's going to be speaking. Let's skip ahead. Don't know what that says, but sure, it can't be too... Oh!
You have to put a name in.
Yay! The only bit of English I'll recognize. Ah, balls.
Well done! You missed all your
Xbox. I fell into my old... Wow, look. When? What?
Exactly.
Yep, that's me.
Will do.
Will do.
Will do too. D-pad.
Nope, nothing. Uh-huh.
Did the game just lock
Maybe up? Is it loading? Please load. I didn't even move the thing down to...
None of the buttons are working?
Oh.
Go down to done.
I did.
Now I try to move down.
Oh, there we go. What the fuck was that about?
There you go.
Shit.
Nope, wrong one.
God damn it.
Again, Will.
Hey, look, it's done it again. I didn't do it.
Release the R2 button.
Oh, for fuck. Technology, people. It's fantastic when it works.
Yeah, well, make sure you actually hit the right ones. You have to use a different name. Throw a bunch of numbers on it, because this is probably your identifier for your character, and somebody somewhere around the world has called themselves Will.
Whoever done that, you're a dick, okay? Alright. Maybe that's... Come on.
No, it was the first...
Oh, God. The one time!
You got it right the first time, and then you got it wrong the second time. You go!
Oh, God.
Woo! Well done! Right, that was a difficult puzzle.
Thank you. Thank you.
So obviously this is our kind of people are going to introduce us and give us a tutorial and wandering around.
Well, he already looks like a dick, so I think he's the bad guy.
Yeah, he's probably going to be a guy who's going to turn on you. Or he's a friendly rival.
Yeah, he's a dick. He's already a dick. Sure, whatever. Yep.
Mishaka Group. Ready for combat.
Here's Chappy.
So it's played as a third-person shooter. Not too bad. I like that. I like action shooters. Ho-ho!
It's not Takeshi's castle, calm down.
So it's actually just teaching you the basic controls. So mechanics are left stick for movement.
He slides as well. Yep. This is a disc jam all over again. Oh, we got the flash, or a minor.
Now you have to shoot. R2 to normal shoot, L2 to alt shoot, triangle, and L1. It's
got
a groovy beat to it.
How do they have some
weird
wish? Yeah, not that funky right now.
You're gonna try different attacks? Alright, you switch weapons there. Switch back your other weapon. Try the triangle and L1. Good cool. So essentially, this is just an old school game. It's essentially, play, it's just giving you robots to play with in a similar vein as you would in just any kind of third person action shooter. Headshots, body shots, probably you want to be able to hit batteries in specific locations on certain different types of enemies. Makes sense? Any observations, Will?
Oh, sorry.
just went completely silent there for like a good solid 10 seconds and didn't do anything in the game either.
Yep.
Like, did your brain just shut off? It's like,
I was assessing the situation. Okay, guys? I mean, if I can't assess the situation, like, what sort of shooting guy am I? Don't know what fuck I'm at. Words I'm trying to say.
Yeah, you're running out of words even more.
Wow, that is...
So, just... essentially, like, how does it feel combat-wise for characters' movement? Does it actually feel like they are a bit loose, and does it actually, like, auto-lock for you a wee bit, or...?
I'm not sure about the auto-lock. It is what it is. There's no auto-lock. If there's an auto-lock, I can't understand the language to figure it out, so... Oh, balls.
Yeah, I told you to use your... Yeah, so it's teaching you to throw a grenade. You lob them with just R1, and that's all it is, just a single press.
Yeah, you use your right directional pad to look. Good job, thank you. Woo! I can just...
Wants you to take cover. Press exit the wall, yeah.
You think it's talking down to me.
Cover fire and fire from cover. Sweet.
Nice. Okay.
And then if you shot that without pressing L2,
mm-hmm.
It would have given you...
It wouldn't give me anything.
It would have given you cover fire.
No, I tried to shoot.
Alright.
Nothing.
You have to take down these enemies. Clear the area. All the red markers on top of their heads.
No, I got that part. I just want to look around and see what else there was so I can, like, sort of sneaky attack, you know.
Mm-hmm.
So if I sneak up here and shoot this fucker first and then take out the other guy who was trying to shoot me there a minute ago. Load.
Take cover. They can't shoot you behind cover. Yeah. They wouldn't even bother trying.
Yeah, would you? Hello? Does nothing.
So R2. It's L2 and R2 then. So you can't blind fire. That's alright. One of the things you always find, blind fire to be useful. Yeah, just clear it, especially if you've got other people coming through. Or enemies are close enough, you can hit them with a spray.
Yeah. A spray?
Yep, you get them in spray back.
Okay. Right. Okay. Da, da,
da, da, Step two, now to move in combat with your friends.
Ah, bald. I have friends? Yeah, what I just do is just use them as human shields, so I mean, that's not really a tactic as such for them.
Well, you should
understand. Can you actually read that?
Modicum of it, I can actually understand. I get more of it's just contextual, man.
Huh.
I mean, since you're like, I'm looking at this going like, this is the same as every tutorial I've ever seen in my entire life. So you understand what you're doing there? Issuing commands?
Yep.
The different buttons will say move forward, hold
move
that
left,
point,
move right.
Group up on me.
Makes sense, guys? Probably. I don't know. Alright, just get me to the actual game.
So you have to do all three stages?
I know. It's a language bar, it's gonna slow me down because I feel like I'm missing something.
Nah, it's only worry about it whenever you actually see contextual items on the screen.
What the fuck was that?
That was your melee attack? You have to tell your men to actually move and prepare for combat because there's enemies coming. You tell them where to go.
I told one of them where to go.
Now you have to get away from the wall because they're standing at the wall because they think you meant the wall. See there?
Oh shit, right.
Yeah. You have to set a point and point at it and tell them to go there. There you go. So left will be player one, the first guy, right will be the second guy. Yeah, right will be the second guy. And then forward will actually be telling them all to move up. And I move up with them because he said you think the other one guy's taking all the damage. There you go. Gotta work as a team, man. Gotta work as a team.
I gotta get through to these kids. Yeah, this is a bit annoying. It's a bit annoying.
Every game's gonna have tutorials. Remember, this is an online online game, so like it's extremely like they do not want you to go into the gameplay not knowing how to play this game at all.
Yeah, but it's I think I know that, but it, for me, it's mainly like I honestly, God, have no fucking clue what the thing is actually trying to tell me what to do because of the language barrier.
Right, but then that wouldn't help you even if you went straight into the full game either, though. But at least with this, you're actually like they're telling you use the L button. All right, what do you want me to do with the L button?
Walk forward and walk back. What the fuck did I just do?
I want you to look up at an item.
No, but that's not even me doing that.
Hi. Move to the location and made you look up. That was actually showing you that was an ammo resupply, which was red. Health resupply is green.
Right.
How'd you so get... just send a guy to that. You can pick up health by sending somebody else to it. To it now. Oh, or you didn't even have to, you just sent them up there.
Mm-hmm. Just so you know, my robot friends are gonna die a lot in this.
You know, it's only robot friends in this bit.
Yeah, I know, but well, even still.
So there'll be real people in the rest of it.
You sure it's not gonna give me robot friends?
I think this is a squad based game. I mean, unless nobody wants to play with you.
Well, that sounds about right. And what the fuck just happened to me there, boys?
It's just showing you what happens whenever you die and respawn. Gives you how long it'll take for you to respawn?
10 seconds? 10 minutes?
Well, it matters on each one. 8 seconds.
24. Wow, damn. That's kind of quick. I suppose it's a
tutorial.
It's a tutorial.
And then R will allow you to choose which respawn point to use. R stick. And then circle. Select.
Respawn where you just died.
And now to fight a boss.
Brilliant. It's always good to fight a fucking hovercraft of some sort. That's trying to use active camouflage.
Probably implying that's not real, just that's a VR construction or something. I want you to stand on that point. You said that last guy all the way down.
Yeah.
D-pad. Stand there and the fight will begin probably. There you go.
I just have to get used to it.
Alright, take cover. Might be helpful. And start the fighty fight. Told him to start shooting.
Fair enough. Sure.
One up there.
Oh great, I went to duck up and it just...
Must have spotted you.
Yep. Doesn't like me.
Watch out, everybody combined back on you again.
Yeah, that was weird. I told them to...
Yeah, well, I mean, they moved up on you just.
Alright, boys, I'm gonna send you back off over... Nope. Shit, what did I do there?
Send way off the back. You didn't even know anything?
There, that's better.
Again, he, like, that wasn't pointing to anything. He's not in cover.
No, it's behind the wall.
Now he is.
Yeah.
There you go.
Well, I had it there, and then it actually moved it up because of the screen menu's in my way.
Oh yeah. Hit its small red bits for maximum damage.
Yep. Aha! I defeated you for now, Team Rocket.
We're blasting off again.
Ah, oh, God.
Prepare for trouble and make it double. protect the world from devastation, to unite all people within our nation, to defend the truths of...
If their trouble's always double, then wouldn't it be quadruple? Because we know because it's team. Wouldn't we know they expect double?
Quadruple, you know? Trouble?
Yep.
But the fact that there's only three of them,
yeah.
Yeah, so it's actually not quadruple?
There's four of them, actually. Well,
wow, then, my fat!
Don't forget, there's the purple snake.
No, they had Ekans and Coffin as well, but they didn't really have them, like, them out of their balls all the time. They only used them in combat.
Yeah.
And even then, they stopped doing that well into the game. So they became Arbok and Weezing. And then later on, they got a Wobbuffet, which would just show up and mess up their day every once in a while. So it's actually showing you all the different types that you can actually select from.
Captain America!
The first Avenger bot. Okay, so you do actually have to get a couple of units of working out. So this is actually your team of three. Bottom button in the bottom right.
No. I got that. I was just seeing why that thing up there was flashing, but it didn't let me do anything
until that's off the screen. You can see the group chat in the bottom left corner. That's actually live chat with people playing the game.
Not one word of English.
Of course it wouldn't be. This game isn't actually available in the UK or Europe or anywhere that English is spoken yet.
I'm going to say hello.
Feel free.
If I can figure out how to do that.
Circle selected?
Yeah, it's not working. Unless right. I have to do it up here somewhere. Awesome. Oh, wait, no, wait.
Square.
Nope.
Try square actually on the box.
No.
No. And that case, you have to have a keyboard picked up or some other way of managing through it. So if you try the wee flashy one at the top corner, that'll actually probably take you into the actual combat of the main game.
No. It might actually be the home screen I have to go to. Or it might be... No.
Try triangle then. So it's essentially showing buttons of things to do, but it actually seems to be a very slow response. Remember, like, since it was actually having difficulty responding to you whenever you're trying to go through menus, so it might be doing the same thing now.
Yeah. Nothing on that.
None of those seem to be highlightable.
Nope.
None of your options are allowed. Maybe you have to speak to these guys first, then.
Or I can select them as me avatar? I'll pick the hot chick.
Okay. Oh, that's what it is.
Pretty much.
So all those other options are locked until you finish going through these menu systems.
These are add-ons or power-ups or something?
Power-ups and skills, I imagine.
Sure, why not? I mean, I can think of a few reasons, but why not? Sure, why not?
Any special events that are actually on at the moment? Probably saying the launch day or whatever else it is, the main screen. Just put text and clothes on. You're not going to be able to read any of it.
Nope.
Hatsune Miku appears again. Okay, so this is like daily awards and reward allowances. So if you actually came in and logged in every single day, you would unlock and get more of these items, which would give you in-game stamina or health or whatever else. Essentially, like, they're bonuses for completing achievements. It's you know, like, typical any of those games or MMOs that just kind of, like, if you come back every
single day...
Thank
you for logging in. You have 600 points.
Yeah. Yay! And you get 1,200 if you come in the next day, and then you get 1,400 the next day, and then continues on. Exponential growth.
Okay. Right, let's blow some shit.
Oh, there's actually a proper full intro.
Kind of wish it was two players, so you could take one of the guys and I didn't have the boss at a round. Ah, shit.
Well, if we had two consoles, we were playing this in two different places, then yeah, we could do that.
Well, I would have to get it on a... On my console?
You would have to make an account that was for Hong Kong or for Japan. Which is easy to do.
This seems to be two different.
There's other people playing with you. Dropped you into a game. You're the green team.
Yes, and reds. I know I'm the blue. I think I'm with the blues.
All right. You spawned in at the same spot. Don't always aim for red.
I can go there.
Well, that's them all dead. Oh, no, there's one left. Take that point. Since you have, let's say, point by point, so you actually have to move forward, claim a point, move forward, claim a point, move forward, claim a point.
Checkpoints, basically.
Yeah. Well, I mean, imagine, it's kind of like, reminds me more of, like, say, League of Legends or Smite or whatever else. Maybe it's actually, that's why you have a loadout that you can change every single time, so that you have different skills. So it's taking a MOBA style, applying it to a third-person shooter, which is pretty cool. You're going to stay back there and actually claim that point.
I had claimed this thing.
That one is claimed, yeah. Yeah, that one's got.
Yeah, but if it is like, it keeps pointing those. Well, no, yeah, I know what that is, never mind. Okay, robot lady. You're not in my head now.
Blue team caught that point, and you have balls to take down the boss. It showed you where the weak points were. Maybe there's another one on its belly.
Yeah, I just need to get my two men over here because they're too far in the open.
You don't seem to be getting shot at all.
Yeah, but their thing seems to be in red. What's that about? There we go, I just told them to shoot at it. And then I got pissed.
There's ones on the floor there as well, the smaller enemies.
Yep.
So you kill the ads, and that way you let the rest of them shoot the bosses. That way these guys aren't going to get us hit as much.
Yeah, I'm getting shot anyway, and I shouldn't hit that button.
One left down there.
Yeah, but the blue guy's got that.
What, the wee small guy?
The blue guy's got him. I'm just going to shoot this thing. Yeah, it's flicking around in traditional boss fashion. Okay, yeah. Guys, back here. Ah, shit, did it go? Ah, never mind.
Send them forward to attack. The blue guy's dead. Just yourself, don't you?
Well, they don't want to move.
You told them not to move, though. That's what that button does.
Oh.
That's stop. No, that's going to form on me. Oh, more guys dropped to the ground. Hit the red bits.
Huh. Balls. Well, my guys are dead.
Yeah. Respawn in 15 seconds. Blues are coming in now. Take back that point. Keep fighting the boss. Nearly dead. Watch out. It can't hit you at that angle. Just keep killing it.
Yeah, but there's no point. Just none of its weak points are open yet.
Yeah, but you're still doing damage. Look, they're biting the crap out of it. There's red ones on the floor right next to you now.
Shit. Oh, I'm dead.
Yeah. Just wait until you respawn. Yeah, successful, you were dead. Your teammates finished it off.
Nice.
So, what do you think of Figurehead, as essentially, it feels like it's a very standard third-person shooter that just uses a robotic skin, which makes sense, because it means that you can actually have these bigger, weirder boss fights that are actually things floating in the air, but it feels very, very, like, run-of-the-mill. It doesn't seem to actually, like, there's no
if
speed.
If I had more time to play it, I think I'd get into the video, but it's just...
I feel very slow.
Personally, for me, being a non-gamer, which, you know, you gotta remember... Like, it's been a long time since I've played a lot of stuff. The language, I'm looking solely at the language as the way to communicate what the fuck's going on. And you look at it and go, oh, that's this, that's that, and that's that. And you already know instantly what it's... Because you've been playing for so long, different games.
Mm-hmm.
I'm still like, I don't know what's going on. Jesus Christ.
You need the instructionals?
I just need it to be in English so I know what the fuck I'm doing. Just even give me a sort of... the sort of get me to point B or point C.
It's just one of those things. Whenever I see games like this, I actually see the mechanics and how they actually like going like, ah, that's that.
I don't know, look at this, look at this. That's it, whatever the fuck. Success or something. Or push that thing down there.
All right, so it's pointing you at an object that has a wee red light on it, right below it. Go left. I see that. It's trying to get you to go there. Now see where that is on the screen, on the far left. Up, 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 there. They want you to bring that up. Slightly up, slightly lower, that one, yeah.
Jesus. Give me a mouse.
And then if you, this is actually to unload your items or upgrade your gear or select items that you actually have for stamina or weapons. But if they leave it at the bottom right corner down there, they're still tutorializing you at the moment.
Yeah, I'm just going to do whatever I can to keep the gun.
Yeah, just leave it. Just don't select anything. Leave it as it is and then go down to the bottom right corner where it's flashing. And there you go. You receive all those items. That's the loot that you got from completing that mission.
You're so used to this. I'm fucking like, nope. Question this.
Hit the button again. There you go. More items got. All received. Now you can leave that screen. It'll be the back button.
Nope.
Yeah, in that case, you actually just have to select a different menu on the top. You can press triangle. That would have taken you back. This is the way it's showing you different kind of options for different kind of combat and scenes and whatever else. Like, that's showing you for... I think that's actually to unlock different armor gears, because it's actually showing you different armor types. So that's an R bit in one of the other screens.
Oh, can I actually go into this thing now?
Yeah, for setting up for going into missions. So you're searching for a mission. You work your way across the board and claim an area again.
It's Blockbusters.
Yep. Robotic Blockbusters.
Although I get the fact I need to complete each area. I mean, unless I can go straight across.
Yeah, it goes straight across, but you'd actually have more access to more items and more places and whatever else.
That didn't...
Well, that's your base one. Choose the one that's not your base.
No, unless...
Go on.
No, I've completed... That's what I just did, so... Right. Why didn't it let me go and do the one... I just select it unless I need something for it. Or sure. Oh no, it's gonna give me. I'm gonna replay it again.
You're gonna be replaying that same mission?
I think that's what's gonna be, because if I've clicked on it and I've gone through the wee thing down the bottom, it's probably gonna get me to replay the one I just did.
See? Yeah, it is the exact same one. Yeah.
My familiarity.
And now
shit.
You're intuiting.
Yep. No, I wouldn't say that. You don't say that. I'm just gonna send them all the way. I'm just gonna send my two robots all the way up to the back. I wouldn't do that. I had to do the stages. Yep.
It's worth giving it a try, but you can't, sadly.
Nope. I'm just gonna leave them behind. Fuck them. The ground. I want to be the war hero, or war bot.
Space unlocked.
Boom goes the dynamite. No way.
Captured.
Oh, wait. Oh, yeah, my health's gone up.
Yeah.
Good.
The sound's not going to be...
There we go.
It's actually the battle started.
It has the way to activate.
Have you got grenades?
That's what I'm trying to see if I've got here.
What's the R1 button?
No. Yeah. That,
you have to get it on top.
Spectacularly went...
You need to actually get it on top of it. You have to lob it onto its back.
I don't think I'm going to do that from down here.
Yeah, one's on the ground, but you can hit those guys with a grenade. No, too late, because they're already out of that area. I'm gonna rush your guys.
Wow, that it takes a long time for the fucking grenade to reload too.
Yep, well, it said to you it's on a cooldown. Be left alone because all those blues are down now.
Yeah, same as like the first time.
I think it's almost like a scheduled attack.
Oh, nice.
You left your teammates behind, didn't you?
Somewhere.
Take that point to recover.
Yep. Yeah, so this time I actually get a respawn.
So where's your guys?
They should be...
There yeah, they are now.
Coming up now.
And that thing's over the top of your head now, so there's going to drop some red guys right next to you.
Great. Where I sent my fucking robots, they are getting shot.
Yep. Drop red guys next to you now. They're on the floor.
Yep.
They just melee. Like, imagine melee is unbelievably destructive. It can probably take most people and low level enemies out in a single strike. Audio was off.
Hmm. Oh shit, I forgot I can pick my spawn point. Yep. Forgot about that.
Oh, so it's actually invincible again because you were dead? You have to reactivate the fight? That's, oh, because they take the point? As long as they have that point, you can't actually hurt that enemy? That makes sense. Essentially, it stops the people from actually like jumping back every single time.
Oh, shit.
Yeah. Imagine, does it actually reload that guy as well every single time where he gets more energy?
I don't know as much now. Once the red guys jump down here, I should be able to shoot them from behind.
Well, they'll turn around at you.
Well, yeah, but...
I was going to say, grenade them immediately and you would actually... Then you take all four of them out in a single shot. Now he's nearly dead. Almost there. Ooh. Weak spot.
Hey!
And done.
Not too bad. Should I play a bit?
No, I think I'm good. This is a third person. Is this a third person? Do you want me to bring down your gamer score?
Yeah. Bring it down.
So yeah, it feels like it feels slow.
It is a bit.
Does it feel like does the robots actually feel like there's weight to them, but they actually feel very clunky?
I think eventually, if you play it long enough, you know, you get your upgrades, obviously, make it faster and quicker and all that bullshit. But it does seem a bit slow. Like, you know, if there's a run option, I'm not gonna be able to hit it because if I hit it, I'm sure it'll fucking kill somebody, mainly myself. So yeah. It's all right. It's not too bad.
Yeah, it seems to be just a standard third-person shooter that just, like I said, has a robot skin, which is fine. I mean, there's nothing wrong with that. In fact, I would actually enjoy the
hell of it. I'd say this is still better than fucking Commando 7.
Or Operation
7. Damn it. No, it was one of the two. I don't care how sluggish or slow this as a game was, Mech Warriors or whatever it is. Fucking just, Operation 7. Just, no, you're bad taste.
Let's see here. What have we got?
You have hexagons.
Yeah, I'm seeing if these are actually pre-made missions or if they're actually online missions or what.
Yeah, I suppose we'll find out. In the next episode, no.
In the next special episode of Dragon Ball Z, Goku screams for the next 17 minutes. Is this the tutorial thing all over again?
You just went into the tutorial, yeah. There's a strong chance you just did.
Oh, man. Come on. If this doesn't let me skip out of the tutorial immediately, I am going to... There we go.
Nice! See, your intuition has a... And actually has a bit of Japanese backup, too. You know what the fuck you're doing.
But again, it's like menu option down to the bottom that actually
says. See, menu option, you knew where you're going. If I was doing this, if I had the control in my hand right now, I feel like you'd be shouting down in the bottom, down in the bottom. I'd be looking and going, wait, which one could it be? Where am I going? I'm looking at the thing. You already intuitively know where to go.
Ooh, that's where it's saying season one.
Oh, balls.
Season one appears to be the actual like active content currently going on in the game. So I was playing a game, this was ages ago. It was actually a Gundam game based on a similar idea like this, where there's seasons where there's certain characters that you unlock and can play through. So you actually get to, if you play through season one, you get to have these X items. So it encourages you to actually play with these characters.
Funny enough, I just realized that the logo of the girl that popped up there, I know a girl looks like her too.
Well, that one was super busty though.
Yes. Yes,
the girl that you're thinking of is super busty too.
Super busty with pigtails. Like, or the hair like that. Yep.
Damn those blondies.
Mm-hmm. What do you do? What do you do?
Motorboat?
Yep, that's a fair assumption.
That's a horrible thing to say, but yeah. Well, but yeah, but no.
No. Yeah, no. I mean, it was rhetorical, but sure.
Okay, so which one am I taking? No, don't get to choose them.
Nope.
I just got to use them.
You got to pick one of these two things. Why was it not the right one?
There's no right choice.
There's no right choice. There's never a good choice. Only a choice.
Bot game. All green. 曲がり角の先に操作に条件を. Whatever it is you wanted to tell me, it's too late. Ooh, looks like a cool design.
That's a different one.
Nice. Oh, this is actually like a timed event of some sort. Happy days. And I move a lot faster.
Oh, that one fair. That one really shot back.
Yeah.
God damn. I don't know what she's saying. Run, bitch, run. No, she's Jenna in your fucking forest, running around shooting shit.
Whoa! Ooh. Shit, that actually hurt.
That took quite a bit of your health.
Yeah. You get back to a point. Oh, right in the face.
Murder bot, death, kill bot.
Oh, I respawned. Sweet. Where do I respawn to, though?
Come on, where's your map? Oh, not too bad. Not too far back. Still being timed. Pew! Huh. Well, I guess
oh, shit, he's gonna fire. Yep, there we go.
You get it. Make it to the point. This thing.
Oh shit.
Okay, keep running.
I know. I'm just gonna throw a grenade at him. I'm gonna respawn and reload.
And awesome.
Boom, success. 1:26. So I'm assuming each of these modes are actually kind of like just a competition.
Yeah, mode. So you can figure out what the retry button is. I will give it a time trial.
You gonna give that a try?
Fuck, I'd be three. Oh no, you got 1 out of 3 stars.
No, I got 3 stars?
No, there's 3 stars up there, but one of them's gold, the other two are white.
Alright.
To 1 out of 3.
Okay, but I thought I beat the score. It said 1:30 for the 3 stars.
No, because it's the first time we've played it, you've set the...
Oh, I set a record? Okay.
Yeah, see, I know some other games. Remember the time one we were doing? The car. The car was like... What that fucking game was? I can't remember.
Oh, Trackmania?
Yes. See...
That video never made it up online. The audio was garbage, so I couldn't actually put it up. I wouldn't mind playing Trackmania again sometime for like a... Did you actually buy Trackmania in the end up?
No, God no. Yeah. I didn't have a PlayStation at the time.
Oh, well, I bought it. Oh, wait. No, you did, because you played Trackmania with me online afterwards. Remember they had the trial?
Demo.
Well, it was a trial, because it allowed you to play the full game for like an hour.
Oh, motherfucker. How much we're talking?
We're going to move on.
Yep.
Short.
Yeah.
Nicely done. Got him.
Fucking reload all the time.
Just watch your clip.
Oh yeah, sit down there now.
Do you use L2 to iron sight?
Only sometimes. God damn it. And I'm out of fucking grenades, actually.
They reload. Well, they have to respawn. What do they call it? Cooldown. Boom, 14 seconds faster.
See if it gives me 12 seconds. See if it gives me another star. Why am I just...
Yeah, 3 stars.
One. There's 3 stars there for...
That's the time at the bottom that's reading. 1 minute 30. Anything below 1 minute 30 gets you 3 stars.
Why is that 1 star gold and the other 2 stars are white?
It's because it's an overlay. It's actually... like it's only because that pipe is in the way that makes it look darker.
I don't know.
I'm pretty sure, because it wouldn't show 3 stars unless it was 3 stars, like. Gonna move on to the next mission? Give it a try?
Sure.
Because it'll be a different background, so therefore it won't be the same problem.
How long have we been playing this?
We've been playing
fucking ages?
This. 45 minutes.
45 fucking minutes?
Yep.
Shit. That one went... This is going quite long.
It does show. I mean, this has gone really long, but it's also kind of enjoyable. I could actually see myself throwing some more time into it. Did you realize it was 45 minutes?
I said 20. I did not realize.
Do you want to call it a day and we actually might come back to this another time? Because Figurehead's actually got our attention.
Holy Christ.
And it's a free-to-play game.
Yeah. Get out your PlayStation freebie. Jesus.
Oh, what's this?
Obviously.
This is made in Japan. It's not a PlayStation freebie.
Oh, well, then...
Because PlayStation Freebie is for PS Plus. This is made in Japan because this game is not out over here yet. And I could really get into playing this if they actually did a European translation of it. I mean, I can play through this probably fine just because
We'll bang about a tweet and be like, here, guys, it's kind of cool. Could you run Google into the fucker?
Instead you just Google API.
Google Translate the thing.
Well, I imagine they probably have to source servers and all that kind of crap. But I mean, this is one of those games that actually, like, catch me off guard. I didn't... forward to it, didn't know it existed, but I'm actually enjoying it, and I enjoyed it about as much as I enjoyed playing the Gundam kind of like online first person shootery or third person shootery game that was out. So this actually has that same feeling without actually having the branding and the association with Gundam that actually has to happen.
So it's like its non-branded cousin.
Yeah, it's a non-branded cousin. It's the GoBots to their Transformers.
Yeah.
So this is GoBots the video game with none of the transforming. But guys, actually, thank you very much for watching. This has been Figurehead here on PlayStation 4 for an episode of Made in Japan.
Made in Japan.
So if you actually enjoyed what we're chatting about here on the station, make sure to hit the subscribe button right up there. It'll be sitting where that hexagon is, and it'll actually allow you to be able to watch stuff as it comes out here on the channel. And over here on the right, a couple of videos over the top of Will's head, they can point out for you. They are all videos of stuff that we've done here on the channel and other games for other different series that we've done. Yep, those ones up there. You want to see them? They're up there. So, thank you very much for watching, guys. We'll see all you dudes in the next video.
Bye.
Bye.